Let us look at the example of convolution sum, where for the given system, x of n is given as 1, 2, 3, 2, and h of n is given as 1, 2, 2. In this example, both sequences x of n and h of n, their starting point is 0. Therefore, our output after convolution sequence will be arranged with the starting point at 0. In the output sequence, overall, there will be 6 number of samples, which are calculated as 4 samples from x of n plus 3 samples from h of n minus 1. So this formula tells us how many number of output samples will be there for the case when both x of n and h of n are finite duration sequences. Using graphical method, initially by changing the index small n to m for both x of n and h of n, we sketch x of m and h of m. Followed by that, we obtain the folded impulse response h of minus m, and we calculate the first output sample y of 0 by multiplying x of m and h of minus m for the positions of m where both sequences overlap. So in this case, for x of m and h of minus m, they overlap only for m equal to 0. Thus, the result of convolution sum will be 1 multiplied by 1, that is 1. Next, we calculate y of 1. For y of 1, now we should obtain graphically h of 1 minus m. Hence, the folded signal is now shifted by 1 unit to right. Further, we multiply x of m and h of 1 minus m for the positions of m where both sequences they overlap. So there are two such positions, that is at m equal to 0 and m equal to 1, where their amplitude levels will get multiplied and we add the product values to obtain y of 1. In this way, we continue to obtain h of 2 minus m, h of 3 minus m, h of 4 minus m and h of 5 minus m. And one after another, we calculate the output samples from y of 0 up till y of 5. Since we have initially calculated that the total number of output samples will be 6 and the starting point of the output sample is 0, this is why we start with the amount of shift from n equal to 0 to n equal to 5, and thus we obtain the output of convolution, which is listed here. Same example, when we solve using the matrix method, we arrange x of n as the row values and h of n as the column values. Then we multiply row and column elements to fill the elements of this matrix. Followed by that, we partition the matrix elements diagonally, and those diagonal elements, they are added when in the diagonal, there is more than one element. Those elements, they are getting added. And we obtain y of 0, y of 1, y of 2, y of 3, y of 4, and y of 5. Where the output remains same as calculated in the graphical method.